writer who once said, love is just a word until there's this someone very special who came and, you know, who gives it a meaning. Anyone can catch your eyes. It takes that very special person to catch your heart.
In the past few days, we met lots of couples from Muscat, and from them we wanted to choose the ideal couple.
It's close to impossible to choose ideal couple.
Yeah, it is a little subjective, isn't it?
Yeah, it's like, I met this couple, you know, recently, and asked them if they're the perfect couple. And then this person says, we are the perfect couple, but not in the perfect situation.
How true. Actually, all of us, or all the couples here, are perfect couples in some way or the other. And made for each other, isn't it?
Made for each other?
Yes.
I guess every couple is made for each other.
Ladies first, she was.
That's another bias I see. I'm unobjective.
I'm objective.
We are married since more than 24 years. This is 1st December 2013 will be our 25th silver jubilee.
My name is Murli Pillai, and my wife, Savitha. Okay. We've been married for 24 long years, but we'll agree that we don't look that old.
My name is Raman, this is Savi. I'm working for the Philippine channel as a correspondent in Oman. And my Savi is working with us to you to come to the university. We've been married for 21 years, and during the 21 years, life is all full of surprises.
I'm Savitha, this is Sangeeta. We are married from 92 onwards. In fact, it was an arranged marriage. We met through a common friend. From Bobby's house.
My name is Kailesh. My lovely wife, Neetu. I'm into trading of building materials. And we've been in Oman for quite some time now. More than 34 years. All our life. We are actually ex-ISM students.
We are Samir and Deepa. As far as our meeting is concerned,
Let me introduce you. my husband Samir. He is working with Mitsubishi. So the born Indian, I would say the Indian heart, but the Japanese mind.
Yeah, it's been an absolute
happy Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day to one and all.
Happy Valentine's Day to everyone.
Happy Valentine's Day to you.
And the process is a very simple process. Like, first you see each other, then slowly you talk with each other, hi, hello, very easy, chatter patter, typical.
When we last met, I still remember the day because I'm not used to wearing saris. I just grew up in sharp pants and jeans. So just because I'm going to see this guy, I wore a sari and I found it so revealing and cold. We had to climb 3 floors in a common friend's house to the topmost floor. It was windy, I was shivering. I just nodded my head to everything he asked. I just didn't listen anything to him. This was more scary to see a person, especially through an arranged match.
Since we were schoolmates, we just knew each other, as in like we've just seen each other and things like that. We stayed just 2 buildings across each other. We played in the same playground, but still, you know, we never got an opportunity to know each other as such. It was after our schooling when we got back to meet our ex-teachers. We hardly met them and we bumped into each other there. And since then it just started off, it was just a casual affair. To be very frank, we never thought it would end up something like this. This is like one of the few ISM love stories that ended well, I guess.
Actually, when I first met her 27 years ago, I found my soulmate. And that soulmate comes, it's just like full of surprises.
I met him about 25 years ago. We had an arranged marriage like he told you. It didn't start off well for me. And I wasn't too sure that he was the guy for me. But somehow like I got around meeting him again. And that clinched it because I found him to be a very easygoing person and a very mild-tempered guy and fun-loving guy. So, you know, we met this for the second time and that clinched it. We decided to get married and then life's been really good since then. It doesn't feel 24 years. It actually feels like we just got married some years ago. So we got 2 kids, 22 and 20. But life's great. I think that marriage is something everyone should definitely make a goal.
Everything happened as per God's will. It was really, I could say that it's really marriage made.
This is the proposed marriage, the proposal came. But the shocking thing was that his first year's job, and he wanted to come for Diwali vacation. So he did all his shopping as if the marriage is already finalized. And right from suit, whatever the gifts to be given for the girl side and all, well prepared. He came on 4th November 1988. And 6th, we had a program to see each other. And immediately on 13th November, we got married.
The 13th November engagement and 1st December
88 we got married. It was like everything within 2022 days because of short of me. So his plan was successful
as if it was. So
you found your Shah Rukh Khan. Unlike others, we have a lot of disconnects. I like something that he reads, he likes something else. I like basic, something in basic, see the tourist trip. She loves mountaineering, I love sitting on it, watching it. But my dad used to tell me, you are good in mechanics, he is good in electronics, so he have a kid who is good in electronics. He didn't know what is it, that is it, mechatronics.
Our house is also like just opposite to each other. So the office place also just opposite, the gate was also exactly opposite. So we just go and come then. First few days I thought he is following me.
So you were tere ghar ke samne and tere office ke samne.
Yeah.
So this was...
Since then there was no looking back. Marriage was not a bed of roses. We had too much problems. Since we fall from different religious backgrounds and things were bad then. But then we somehow managed. We had to elope all the way from Muscat to Bombay. It was an international jumping
off.
International lafra with a little pocket money and stuff like that. We somehow arranged tickets for ourselves and we had to elope. We were too young to understand actually what's what. But the only thing we knew was like we wanted to be with each other, that's all. And the only thing was like you get married so you're going to be with each other. That was the only concept we had.
No, we don't even touch each other in Bombay.
My order answers when you go for shopping. Otherwise, you run away.
We have seen many colors of life, and of course, lot of ups and downs also. But the lovely thing is, we are still together.
I think we are a classical example of what two extremes in life can mutually attract each other. Even I had to ask him for the maths because he's the person with maths and finance, handling business in the house, and I'm doing the rest of everything else. So we have a successful formula because we complement each other so damn perfectly. Because if he was just like me, I would be so damn bored. Or if I was just like him, life would have been so normal, so ordinary. But we find a ground footing each other to be balanced. And probably it's like the yin and the yang. We are perfectly balanced as a married couple for the past 21 years.
What I like the most about her is that she's so sporting. She always participates in any kind of mad activities which I get into. Because I'm quite a restless person, I indulge in various aspects. And of course, she herself has got a lot of talent. She's a very good singer, though she doesn't accept that. So I keep forcing her to sing once in a while.
For me, she's very confident. She like any topic you give her, she can talk. I'm very...
I think that's a bad point.
No. It's a good point because
normally I see this lady's bugging us once. She doesn't look that's a great thing.
Today I did not paint my nails. I don't go to the parlors. I don't really need anything to cover my white hair because he's just like, he says, I like you just as you are. And that's the same with me. We have not changed for each other. And that's a pure attraction factor.
Caring, I know it's like everyone's caring, I know, but it's like, you know, if there's a small pimple, I get 50 calls, he'll go through the net, check which cream can be used, which what can be used, and like he'll give a 50 calls, has it suppressed, has it gone down, has it, you're okay, you're fine. So it's like I'm like too pampered and I feel like, you know, sometimes I think it's like father figure.
We even compromise living together for a while so that our
career has to go.
That sentence is really
really good. Very good. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, you better explain that after the video is done.
The thing about I hate about her is that she eats a lot. Because you know, I told her, hey, during the first time I met you, you're still 24 or something like that, sexy. And then I told her, stop eating a lot. And then I could understand because she's breastfeeding my baby. But even if she grow big, she will still the love of my life. Because I found my soulmate in her.
He's like too finicky, he's too clean. The decisions are not clean. Of course, I'm like very neat and I see that everything's in place, but still he'll scratch out something from somewhere. Oh, this is like that. That is like, he's too finicky and very, very forgetful. Okay. Very forgetful, like just like any, I think all guys are very forgetful. They don't remember dates and all that. But
I'm
yeah.
Okay with dates, I think.
No, oh, it's only a few.
He needs kajur.
Yeah.
Badam.
He needs badam. Although he's had ample and more, but still.
I would say he's very quiet, he's to himself, he has to communicate because communication is a key to marriage. And if you communicate, I know what he has in his mind, what he wants to say, it could be better, I could be better. I could do something, you know, what he really wants. Because if he had to just
express
speak,
himself,
oh yes, yeah. Communicate, that's very important for a successful marriage.
She's more talkative. One way is good for me, that I'm silent, I don't have to talk much. But I have to keep my ears open. Maybe both ears open.
This is the all the feminine characteristics extraordinary. You can talk
more of these.
That's true.
So, like people take for talk that some girls born with a loudspeaker, but she came with an amplifier.
One more thing. Today is a birthday.
Birthday.
Exactly.
Oh. So you can listen.
One way it's good for me that both occasions fall on the same day.
It's Morris's birthday.
Some excitement. I am in the rush because I have to gift her a very car.
Oh, that's great, that's great. Oh. Another surprise, a big surprise.
Mitsubishi.
Yes.
Is it going to be Mitsubishi?
No.
My demand was just a very packed hatchback car because parking and you know here everything is difficult for us.
Mitsubishi car is a bit complicated for her too.
Actually, she runs very well.
Okay.
But I cannot dance.
मेरे हाथ में तेरा हाथ हो सारी जन्नतें मेरे साथ हो
तू जो पास हो फिर क्या ये जहां तेरे प्यार में हो जाऊं फना
I'm on the top of the world looking down on creation and the only explanation I can find is the love that I found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me on the top of the world.
Fantastic.
What's the most embarrassing situation she put you through?
I try to keep away from it. Less opportunities for such things.
But this is an embarrassing situation to me, but it may not be to others.
He steals all my girlfriends. You think he's so silent and he comes up with something right and they say, oh, this guy is romantic in his own way, and I said, okay.
Like, I was embarrassed when she said.
What do you call each other when you're really, you know, when you
feel a lot of love for each other. What do you call her? And I want it with expressions if possible. Please.
I call her madam.
You have to call her like that. I just want to see how. Yeah, you call
madam.
My sweetheart.
I call him Sonu.
Sona.
We match there also.
No, just sometimes by name or as a respect. We don't call him.
With love.
Gurje.
Now, when you're really angry with each other, how do you call her?
You're stupid.